Stacy has saved us $600 a year. $50 a month, Stacy.
Cheers.
If you're watching this, you've saved me $600 a year.
Turkeys are like my new thing that I've been doing for the past year. So it'll constantly be this evolution. All of you, you have trillions of good and bad bacteria. We want the bad bacteria in us, but unfortunately in this day and age, the majority of us, due to lifestyles and the foods that we're eating, we have much more bad bacteria, and the bad bacteria is what's gonna cause sickness and disease and poor health. I really love the Redmond Real Salt because it is mined in our United States in Utah. I'm gonna put the salt on for you guys and then we'll
start squeezing it.
You're gonna just massage it, but don't do that until I give you your.
Yeah, you can go ahead. Don't push, you're not trying to do CPR on it. This isn't CPR, this is massage. Say cheese. All right. Day two of Homesteaders.
And I'm freezing, so I'm putting my gloves on.
It is chilly this
thankfully,
morning.
Thankfully, I didn't take the gloves off the car, and thankfully, Daddy did.
Okay. What are you most excited about learning today?
The painting.
Painting.
I'm painting today.
What are you wanting to learn, Lowry? I'm wanting to learn how to
take care of weeds.
Important stock exchange that there is on the plant, and it is right under your feet. So these perennial rhizome-reducing plants, they're sugar dependent. So your goal, if you want to get rid of them, is you have to deny them the ability to get more sugar, and you have to force them to use up as much of their energy reserves as possible.
What do you think? Do you think we can get rid of the weeds?
I was kind of chased into it without any other option. And the reason why is just my wife and I looking at all this just writing on the wall of what's happening socio-politically to our country, we recognize that one of the greatest ways that we can maintain our personal freedom, autonomy, and security is to be self-sufficient. We do not need to despair because ultimately my hope is not in a utopia or in political leaders fixing it all. My hope's in King Jesus, and he's already won the battle.
People have a deep knowing, an inner wisdom, something that God has put in their hearts that can help guide them for the help.
And the purpose of that largely was because that's a way of living that I believe in, and I like believing in what I'm doing. What do people watch? They watch television. Television is gonna, like I can tell thousands of people, tens of thousands of people to quit watching television, but they're not listening to me. If I tell them that on the television, maybe they'll listen to me then. First 5 years, on a regular basis, every day, as we were filming, I turned to the camera and I would say, I hope you guys would just turn off your television because it'd be a lot better if you would just do it with your own hands. You know, I'd hold up like bloody hands or something and say, put your hands in the blood. You know, you get dirty. But somehow they always edited that part out.
Homesteaders, day two. Day two. What are you most excited about? What are you most excited about? Well, kind of day three, yeah. What are you most excited about?
Eating breakfast.
Eating breakfast. What are you most excited about?
I think my big takeaway.
The worm farm.
You want to hear about the worm farm? You look cold, but it's not really that cold. That dude behind you doesn't even have a jacket on.
Hopefully you leave here with a lot more questions than you already have, right? So that's how we learn stuff, in case you didn't know. Back in the day, medical school, like you're a student and you ask a question of the faculty, you've got a question back.
Facts about how
plants and animals and soil and sunlight and rainfall work together that make it possible for people to have homesteads that don't rely on
cash. So we're not eliminating cash, but we are saying, where can we stop most of the cash going on?
You're dialed in. You're here at an event like this. You're thinking the what if questions already. Like, what if I needed to feed my family?
And that's what I got into worm farming. And after applying myself year after year after year, we now make 2,000 pounds of compost in 6 square feet of space. And I think that's a pretty big accomplishment because it means that we're not reliant on these outside sources anymore.
The core issue, the root problem with the reason that many of us are unhealthy, that unhealthiness exists, is this. And so I give my 10 out. It's, the problem is this. We were designed to live in relationship. We were designed to live in relationship. And a core problem with health or wellness is those relationships.
Hello.
All right. So we're just going to talk about the Homesteaders of America conference. You didn't go last year.
Mm-mm.
The kids and I went last year. We actually bought your ticket before you ended up having to go away to Texas for work.
Mm-hmm.
And so last year the kids and I went by ourselves. And we realized how awesome it was. What did you think about this year's conference? Your first conference?
Well, it was good. It was a lot of fun.
Okay.
Learned a lot. We started with Stephanie was doing the fermenting class, and me and Lawson went to learn a little bit more about sheep and how to take care of them. So that was good. But yeah, I mean, and then all the seminars, security was probably my favorite.
John Lovell's talk about homestead security was one that really, he brought up so many things that I would have never considered.
Which means I get to spend more money.
But he talked about, he made very good points that aren't out of the realm of possibility. Like, for instance, if we end up going through another period like we did in 2020 where grocery stores are really scarce to the point where people can't get food and they know that we grow and raise a lot of our food and I store a lot of food. I canned this summer. Mm-hmm. There's people that know that they'll potentially...
Partially because we do YouTube videos.
Right. Well, yeah. But also, like... That's just not something that I ever considered. I mean, naive I've been about.
We have nothing. We killed all the animals off. No food left.
Threw all the cans out.
The cans all blew up in the basement.
I have no storage. Yeah. No, that's something. But
we have no idea what we're going to do when things go down now.
Yeah. No, in all seriousness, that's not something I would ever considered. I'll tell you my big two big takeaways from this. The seminars that I sat in, the talks that I went to, a lot of them, I guess subconsciously did this, were based on health. And so I sat in on Theron Hutton's talk about the peril of sterile. And how, you know, all of our illnesses can be broken down into the breakdown of 3 different kinds of relationships. It would be us and God, us and one another, us and the earth. And that's a very, like, elementary way of, like, describing that, but it makes perfect sense. And I also, I sat in on Emily Toop's talk about reading labels, particularly on like cleaning products and cosmetics and skincare things. She has her own skincare, organic skincare line. And some of that kind of stuck out with me. The fermenting class blew my mind. I had previously in the past made kombucha. I've made milk kefir before.
Mm-hmm. Yogurt.
Usually make my own yogurt, but I never considered that fermenting for some reason. I didn't consider that a... I mean, you start with a culture, I guess. But anyhow, I remember sitting in that class and getting partway through, and I sent Lowry a text in his class, and I said, we're about to get much healthier. Immediately, when Stacy gave us the statistics on sauerkraut, Stacy, off-grid with Doug and Stacy.
Off-grid.
She's the one that taught this class. And so when she gave us the statistics about the probiotics I've been buying on Amazon with $50 a bottle. And I've been buying that because I knew I needed probiotics and I wasn't getting enough in my diet. And she said that it was like just these statistics on the probiotics contained in the sauerkraut. Someone had taken it to a lab and examined it under a microscope. And the probiotics in 2 tablespoons of sauerkraut held more in those 2 tablespoons than an entire bottle of probiotics. Now,
there you go.
We've been buying some expensive probiotics. I mean, I've been buying what I felt like was not top of the line, but close to it.
$50 a month, free.
Well, or just the cost of the cabbage and salt.
Not as good, way better.
Right. So it's kind of a no-brainer. I immediately went, where one of us went on Amazon and canceled the subscription. We're not buying it. We're automatically.
I think I was told.
Stacy has saved us $600 a year. $50 a month, Stacy.
Cheers.
If you're watching this, you've saved me $600 a year. And I don't even like to choke down the peel. I don't even like it. Anyway, that's a big takeaway. I don't know. I just feel like we came back. And if you think back, I've kind of been on this like health journey. I would say probably 2017, I started really like trying to focus more and figure out exactly what was missing. I knew something was wrong with me, and that's a video for another time. But anyway, I started that in 2017, and now we're in 2022. That's been 5 years ago.
And I just now figured out we don't have paper probiotics.
And I just now figured out
how to do it. You live, you learn.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my goodness. That is funny. Anyway, so we just wanted to, like, showcase some of the things that we brought home from this year's Homesteaders of America conference. I will start with, since we're talking about fermenting, I'll start with Stacy's fermenting cookbook. I have already gone through this cookbook and purchased items for about 5 different recipes that I'm going to be making in the next week and get some ferments going. I'm coming in beans, radishes. I've had radishes growing in the greenhouse, not knowing what in the world we were going to do with them. And she said if you would ferment radishes, that the flavor would be more subdued. This is one of the ferments that we made that day. It's honey garlic. We're going to use this for like when
you get sick.
When we get sick.
Like a cold coming on, start feeling little symptoms.
She said if she didn't sleep well at night, if she had been traveling or something like that, she knew her body would be like subjected to like more susceptible to like a virus or something, that she would go ahead and take one of these like 3 times a day and that the flavor would not be bad. But anyway, off-grid with Doug and Stacy. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh my gosh, you've saved us so much money. And I would dare say that, Lord willing, this time next year, we will be able to like thank you in person, hopefully at the Homesteaders of America conference, and say like in the last year we've all gotten much healthier. Next thing we want to talk about is Redmond's Real Salt. This is one of my favorite vendors. That lady was so nice. Ask about the electrolytes, because I had tried them last year. They had given like a few sample packets like this right here to us last year, and I tried them. I don't know why I never ordered them. I think it's because we already had some on like subscription order or something like that. But I asked her on the first day if she had any, and she said yes, she would save one for me. She didn't have many. And I went back, and she had saved this one for me.
Mm-hmm.
So sweet. Julie from Redmond's Real Salt, we ended up picking up a little thing of salt, And then I have a different flavor of electrolyte I hadn't tried before. This one is mixed berry. The container was mango. I knew I'd already liked that. But the one thing that we picked up from them that I'm interested to try is earth paste. So we've gone through several kinds of fluoride-free toothpaste. And I mean, right now we're using...
Hello.
I mean, it's fine. I like it.
Yeah.
It's a char. I use the charcoal. He uses a wintergreen or something.
Yeah.
And it's fine. But I heard someone talking about this.
It has silver in it too, which is what caught my attention.
I heard someone talking about this and how much they love that, this toothpaste. And so I thought it would be really awesome for you and I to go brush our teeth right now, and then we'll come back and give a quick thumbs up or thumbs down.
Huh.
We'll be right back. My teeth do feel super clean right now.
I'm skewed because I have coffee.
Well, I'll tell you, this doesn't have a very strong aftertaste, and I like toothpaste that doesn't taste. Like, there's been times where I brushed my teeth and it was so, like, strong and minty, I didn't want to drink water. This is really...
I like minty for hours.
No.
Personally.
I really like this. This is the Silver Earth Paste Mineral Toothpaste in the flavor Wintergreen. And it does smell strong, but it doesn't taste strong. Okay. So that is Redmond's. Now we want to talk about Tubes & Co. Organics. I went to this talk specifically because I wanted to know what kind of deodorant I should pick. I have gone through the gamut of natural deodorants, like aluminum-free deodorant.
I just don't wear any.
I've gone through that before too. Like, just said, well, not going to wear anything. So Emily Tubes, she told the story about why she created this company. Or why she started this company. It was totally relatable. And somebody at the end of her talk spoke up and said that last year Emily had recommended her deodorant to this lady, and this lady used it for the entire year, and then it worked. And then I raised my hand and said, well, thank you very much for saying that, because the whole reason I sat down in here was to find out about deodorant. And so I picked up two scents of deodorant. This is lavender, and then this one's lime and bergamot, and they both smell not too strong, but very clean. That's the lavender, and then this is the lime and bergamot.
Smell like lavender.
This one smells excellent. I want my armpits to smell like this. Anyway. No, today's the day I'm not wearing. Anyway, while I was over there, I picked up this frankincense face balm. She makes this out of grass-fed tallow, so beef tallow, beef fat. She goes and picks it up. She renders the tallow in her own kitchen. I don't know where they package and process this stuff, but she said she renders it at home. That smells incredible to me. And I've already been using it. It's called frankincense face balm. Ingredients, like four ingredients. Tallow, olive oil, frankincense, that's it.
It's like a moisturizer?
It is a moisturizer. Yeah. And for any of you guys like me who have like middle-aged skin, I think it's so weird to say that I have middle-aged skin.
Dry old man flaky skin.
Yeah, you should start using this. Yeah. This is incredible. I'm so happy about this. The other thing I picked up is nothing that you're going to want to use, because this goes under makeup. It's Flawless Face Primer. This was the one product I had in my makeup bag that I knew I shouldn't be using, was my face primer. I knew I shouldn't be using it, but I had no other, I didn't feel like I had any other options. Face primer's already pretty expensive.
Try to tell her she doesn't need to use any of it. She doesn't believe me.
Well, I absolutely love this. I am going to do I'm going to put this in its own video. I'm going to put all of these Tubes & Co. Organics products in this audio because I love them so much. They're just amazing. And this is the last thing. This is our last big thing. Oh no, it's not the last thing. This is the last thing I picked up. You picked up things that I got one of the last three books that Sean and Beth Doherty had at their tent. When I was in line and she was busy talking to someone else, so I turned around to talk to Sean and actually got to talk to him and question him about something that we've been wondering about. And then when I turned around, the line was long. So I had to get back in line behind like four or five other people. And there was a lady up there who picked up a book and she said, "Oh my gosh, is this the last one?" And I was like, I was already one. I've been standing here this whole time. And I told that guy that I wanted a book and he saved me one of the last three. And so thank goodness. I haven't been able to dig into this yet. I've been reading the Fermenting book, but I'm really, really excited about this. Their talk was so inspiring. How they took their just property that nobody wanted and turned it into something amazing. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So.
Regenerative farming.
Yeah. Do you want to talk?
All right. Toys. Be right back. Lawson got to hear Eustace Conway talk. And we went to his booth, which was the Turtle Island Preserve. Okay. And while standing there to meet Eustace Conway, I saw this fancy dancy little thing. And maybe we can call it an impulse buy, but Lawson was in line. I looked back at him and said, "Lawson, you want to split this with me?" So, anyway.
Stop paying him the money yet.
So I talked Lawson into splitting the fishing rod with me.
Retractable fishing rod.
That thing's super cool. So smooth. Can't wait to use it.
Like, so you got to put the string through this, and then whenever you're done, you got to take it back out so you can push it back in.
Mm-hmm.
Went back to this particular vendor three or four times.
And then
to look at their demo, to look at the equipment. And ultimately, went and got Stephanie, and I think I want to go ahead and get this. It's from LogOx, what it's called. And what it is just, it's got a couple of different things where, like, for firewood, we can cut it up. I can just grab it, throw it on the truck or a trailer or wherever. It's got this spike. You want these pins up, fit in the center, and just drag stuff wherever as needed. If it was something I wanted to split, the whole concept of most of this is to save my back when I'm needing to cut a bunch of firewood. Assume this is a big long log, right? A big long tree that's down. I can just grab it, bring it up, and automatically it's elevated. So now I can just cut with a chainsaw a lot quicker going down because it's already raised up off the ground.
So all in all, this year's conference was a huge success.
Yeah, learned a lot. It was enjoyable for sure.
Oh yeah,
ran into some old friends and met new ones.
Yeah, we have taken away information that is going to help us save money on our farm. I mean, yeah, we're going to save in the probiotics, okay, but as far as, like,
on might our spend farm, a whole lot more after the security.
What we save, we're going to spend for homestead security, but no, I think it was so valuable.
The beauty of a convention like that, you get so many like-minded people, homesteaders that we're able to meet one another, get together, share ideas, share knowledge, share wealth, and it is so beneficial to ourselves, to others, and to the community at large. And I'm truly grateful for that opportunity.
Yeah. It's in addition to being educational, it's inspiring because homesteading is not easy.
Yeah.
Growing and raising your own food, that's not easy. The easier thing to do is not do it. The easier thing to do is go get a job, make money, and go buy the things that your family needs. Mm-hmm. It's the easier route is not to try to do it yourself. But
there may come a time when that's not
an option.
An option, yeah.
And I think for us to be able to know and learn and do for ourselves, that's more valuable than having money. All right. To the Homesteaders of America, thank you so much for putting this conference on. I think it sounds like hyperbole to say, oh, you've changed our lives, but there are things that we came away with this year that will change. Mm-hmm. Will change us, and we're grateful for that. So thank you. And if you guys like this video, and if you enjoy the content that we put out, and if you're interested in homesteading and homeschooling and learning more about being self-sustaining. Chasing escape pigs. Then be sure to hit the subscribe button. Hit the notification bell so that you can be notified every time we post a new video. And please, please, for the YouTube algorithm, please share this with your friends. And we'll see you in the next one. Have a blessed day.
Bye.
Bye.